new structure here.
It's good stuff. I'm Luke Rockwell, Santa Cruz, California. Fighting for a long time. About the Chris White class. The
Blush!
Honored to be here. Stoked to work with you guys and see what we can do here. How I can help you guys out here. I heard we got a couple fighters coming up here. Who's coming up?
Pro debut, we're showing off AKA, man, right there.
Huh?
Yeah.
They're
focused on
the training AKA talent.
How'd you like it with
someone translated? Very good in English.
Very good, very good in English, huh? Alright, you guys got a warm up in it or all of us?
Not yet.
Alright. In our gym, we always start with shadow boxing, and shadow boxing is probably one of the biggest keys where you find your balance, where you find your technique, where you find your rhythm, you can build speed. Don't underestimate it. There's all different types of shadow boxing. So we always start with the three rounds shadow boxing. Let's just get around it just to warm up, and I just want to see where you guys are at. But to really think about as if there's an opponent in front of you, and then we'll do one round by yourself, and then do one round with a teammate where you can work off. Where are you going?
Any guys want to grab the ring, grab the ring.
Always keep the separation in your feet.
That's what a party sort of takes a punch. So always keep that up. Yeah, you can move out. All I'm going to do is back knee. Okay? So one more guy lead. Start. You start pushing the face a little bit. Start walking around. I don't want the outside to go. I'm going to the outside. I'm going to get that outside.
Our big distractions, you want to set ups and energy. Okay, so when I'm working, people like, I think people really underestimate kicking. Kicks can give you such an advantage. You know, using feints with my legs to set up my hands is big for me. It helps me out a lot. And you can also, when you can kick and not really be touched. You know, in boxing, you can cut angles, but there's always that kind of a chance of a lefty punch more so than a kick. You know, you can kick and not be kicked. You know, so outside, especially with, you know, longer guys. Boxing range, you can be a lot better than guys. Still get caught. You'll get caught with that shot. So I really believe in setting up kicks, making them believe that, and I can really open up your boxing game. Little things, subtleties. So the most disguised one for me, what I really like is just a little foot jab. I'm not talking about a lot of people like are used to push kicks from the back, leg, and it's constant, and you know, it doesn't really hurt. You can see it a little more, so you can hurt guys, but they're more visible. The back leg's got to come up, and it gives them time to react and flex up and protect themselves. I like the front leg. I like the front leg. It's quick, and it's just a snap kick. Okay, and you can hurt guys. I can knock guys out. I put them out all the time. Just a little something, because they're not ready for it. What they don't see, you know, is what's going to hurt. You can see it, technically, as hard as you want, still won't touch it. So I'll gauge that distance, I'll be making the thing. I'll work on that in a second. If he beats you on that range, but all it takes, I'm gonna dig my toes. I'm gonna just try to dig them in hurt. So basically it's quick. I'm not gonna show my knee, I'm not gonna do any of that. It's just a lift.
Skipping forward into this thing. This is the most disguised. See you guys jump the board like this? I just want the first one, I want the first one. I want the disguise.
Four or five guys on the bag, give it like a couple tries. We all have three tries each and then rotate through. But here's the, I want you guys to obviously get used to that range. There, and then I want you here. Come over the top. So, here. So there's a process of like, weight. I would keep all my weight on him, so it really doesn't allow him to move. If he tries to shrimp out, there's a time where I pinch my leg, where I can control him so he can't get out that way. So I'm basically gonna keep my weight on him. I'm gonna turn him over. I'm gonna try to do it. So what I do is, I just want you guys to work. As he shrimps out, he starts working around me. I just stay on him. I pick up that back leg. I make him rotate. I just want you to work to get up, okay? I just want to show you a little drill I do, where I just watch how my body just focuses, and I hold position, and then I float. The more you can float, the more posture you can have, the more opportunity you can have to hurt your opponent. You can posture. Posture is power. If you're all tight and you're trying to hold position, doing all this shits and stuff, you can't hurt the guy. You can little round of comes starting to get you anywhere. How you finish fights, you know what? Is it deep posture. So I get here. I might work here. Before he works, he's up. Moving. Okay. When he works here. See, you go, keep going.
Half guard, try to step through the mount.
I want to keep him close to start. I want to kill his posture. I'm going to stay tight. I'm going to pinch my knees on him. I'm going to do whatever I can to hold him tight for me to kill his posture. So for me, my first reaction, I don't want to be square. You never want to be square when you're on the bottom, all right? If I'm on top like I was trying to show, I want to square him up to me. I want to stack him up. He wants to put pressure on me. I feel compromised in this position, all right? So I want to get here. I want to get an angle, get on my hip, be able to threaten them, or be able to escape. So I come here, I control, I pinch the back, my knee right here, controls what posture I can, and I finish off with a hand, so I lock them down. From here, I want to get inside, right? I want to get inside control, so I'm going to do whatever I got to do. Swim in, I'm going to have my little T-Rex arm to block me here. Okay, so from here, once I feel comfortable, I can control. Once I get it down, I like to come into the hip here, okay? Come in with my open hip, the one's off the ground. From here, I'm in on the hip, now I can start creating some distance, all right? Now I come in here and I use my elbow, get his knees tight here, I'll use my elbow to force that out too. From here, I get my distance. Now I can start riding up on the shoulder, all right? Now I can really control his posture, right? So here, he's gonna start chasing me. And now I can come here. I got the control of his hip, so I keep the distance. And I start to work to my elbow, and I get my head up. Once I get leverage on him, I always come right to the back of the head. Okay, like Muay Thai, and you control their posture. You don't hold the guy like this, okay? You hold the guy on the back of the head. That kills the posture, that gives you that advantage. So, same with that style. I don't go back to the back leg because he can still poke his head up and he can follow me. What he can't see, he can't follow me. So when I get to the back head and he tries to pull posture up, I have control. Now I have leverage. The more distance and leverage I have, the more strength I have here with this hand, which gives me everything. Now he can't do nothing. Now here, now you try to follow me. Come on, I'm out.
Don't do that first.
I want you to get all the way up. Don't do that right.
Goose! Goose!
Thank you.